My understanding is this man Del Way lost his faith a long time ago, and he's been faking for a while. And thing about people that are fakers, that are con artists, preachers, is I don't like them. This guy spends all kinds of money, lives in a mansion. It's because he's on television begging for money. But when he's not just begging for money on TV, he's also begging for money in church. That's why I'm saying he's kind of the perfect person to have been searched a million times, and he doesn't even know it, and no one to ever tell him that. All right, so think about people that are perfect to pull pranks on. Well, it wasn't a prank. All right, so basically what happens is I'm doing this government research project where I'm working on a top secret project I can't tell anyone about. I still can't tell anyone about it. And I'm also working on another project for a class on SCADA, which is for like power grid or natural gas or whatever. Like any sort of any like industrial control system, like a factory, the internet in a factory that controls the machine. So it's like automation. So I was working on a project to do security for automated procedures, like whatever, like water treatment. All right, so basically, I'm hooked up with a top secret on a top secret project that I can't talk about right now with a Venezuelan, and he's a PhD from Purdue, and he's from a national laboratory. And I think his project's okay, and I want data. He wants me to invent math without having numbers. It's kind of hard to explain how that was the biggest problem with this project, because I'm okay with inventing math or trying to apply mathematic equations in different ways using computers mathematically to a problem. But he didn't want to give me any numbers for that. When I looked at his like recommended algorithms, I knew some of them, and I know that I have to have numbers for them to figure out which ones work. And he's like, "Well, don't worry about the numbers, just invent math." But he's a Venezuelan, and he has a thick accent. And I explained to him that the big problem is spoofing the entire network for like the solution that he was supplying for this problem of SCADA network securities. And so he told me, don't talk about the network. And so I didn't talk about it during my presentation. I feel like I'm acting like a jerk because my professor specifically told me, don't talk about your part. So I just didn't talk about it. I just zoomed through it. All right, but that was a Venezuelan that told me to. Okay, so I also did an additional project. All right, so this whole time I've been talking about this project I can't talk about. But in addition to that project, I can talk about the project I did talk about. Or I can talk about, because it was my own project that wasn't for his. And this project was basically creating a backup network for a big ass natural gas pipeline that runs like say that you have the oil pipeline that runs from Canada to where does it go? In Oklahoma, does it go to Tulsa? It goes somewhere right there in the middle. That's a big major oil hub. So say that you're running an oil pipeline, you want to have to do security on it. My idea was to have like a lot of different computers spread throughout and distributed storage, and I was going to use blockchain, and I was going to like have a variation of the Merkle tree algorithm that basically was like destructible, so I didn't have to worry about having so much storage, because I was worried about like 3 days worth of data. All right, so basically, I submit this paper to this guy from, where is he? Idaho National Labs or something like that. He's a Venezuelan, obviously. I give him my paper. Apparently, he hasn't given my paper to anyone. Like, he read it himself, and I didn't even present on this paper because this paper wasn't on the project. Didn't pass it on at all. The professor that was my advisor for this class, he was always an asshole to me. You want to talk about talking down to someone. I think he must have been with the FBI. That's the thing. It's kind of crazy when a professor's with the FBI and you're like, you're with the FBI? Like, but I think like a lot of people don't feel like they're with the FBI, because this other professor talked to me. He wasn't a professor. He was a computer guy. He told me, you know, the FBI and the NSA have the same technology. Because he didn't like that I didn't like the FBI. He didn't understand I didn't like the NSA either. It's because I believe in the Constitution, and that's the thing. I really don't think the problem is we got a bunch of dumb, I mean, really dumb. Like, I'm talking about like very, very, like, what does it take to pass on your genes? Fucking. And all I'm saying is a lot of fucking happens because people are pretty. It's not because they're actually working with a functional brain. It's like crazy how when you hate gay people that much and we're gay, that we kind of have this thing where all we want to do is fucking destroy you. And that's the thing. It's like, well, are you going to be my friend now? It's like, I chose my side. I chose gays. I'll go get fucked in the ass. I like it. I don't give a shit. Here's the thing. Y'all think that there's something wrong with me wanting to lick an asshole. You think that I talk about licking assholes in my music that makes me means there's something wrong with me? I mean, seriously. I mean, let's just think about that for a second. Maybe there's something wrong with you. You don't want to get your asshole licked. I mean, seriously. Maybe you're afraid of cleaning up a little bit and seeing what it feels like. I mean, shit. I mean, maybe you just believe in, like, a very limited view of sex, but some of us have been living for a long time, so we have a very expanded view of sex. And so you can think that I'm immoral because of my sexual proclivities, but apparently Solomon was fine, and no one gave a shit about that. And apparently I don't give a shit, and I'll do whatever the fuck I want. So you can judge me, and I'll judge you. And that's the mutual agreement that I think we should have with one another.